Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we will discuss about the Thevenin's theorem. So in the previous session we have discussed about the superposition theorem. And we have discussed about the explanation of the superposition theorem, and we solved some problems on the superposition theorem. So on completion of this session, you could be able to know the Thevenin's theorem statement, and also you could be able to solve the Thevenin's theorem problems. So what is known to unknown? Many laws and theorems are available for solving the networks. So some of them are like Kirchhoff's laws, Maxwell's loop, current theorems, superposition theorems, etc. So Thevenin's theorem is also one of such theorems. So what is actually Thevenin's theorem? What is that statement? So it states that a given network, when viewed from its any two terminals, that is load terminals, can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with a single resistance. That single voltage source is called Thevenin's voltage source, which is given by VTH, and resistance is called Thevenin's resistance, that is RTH. So here it means, it is stating that in a given network, when you viewed from a load side, it can be replaced by the simple voltage source and a single resistor, a single voltage source and in series with a single resistance. Okay, so that single voltage source is called as a Thevenin's voltage, and that single resistance is called as a Thevenin's resistance. So here we are considering one circuit. So this is actual circuit. This actual circuit consisting of a voltage, EMF, R1 resistance, R2 resistance, and a load resistance which is connected across A and B. Now this network we are converting into the Thevenin's network for simplification or for calculating all the values of that network. Okay, so now this is A and B. A load. So from load side, when you view, all the resistance and the voltages are replaced by one single resistance and one single voltage source, and they are in series. Okay, so that is what here this circuit is replaced by one single source and one resistance, which is called as VTH and RTH. This is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit. This is an actual circuit. So, rules to find a Thevenin's voltage. So, while we are applying a Thevenin's theorem, we have to follow some rules. We have to follow by step-by-step procedure. Okay. So, here to calculate the Thevenin's voltage or open circuit voltage, the load resistance has to be removed. Then find the voltage appearing across the open circuit terminals. So we have to remove the load resistance, and from that load resistance we have to find out the voltage appearing at that removed portion. Okay, so removed terminals. So that is VTH is equals to VOC, that is V Thevenin's is equals to V open circuit. And there are some rules to find out the Thevenin's resistance also. Likewise, a Thevenin's voltage. Okay. So, what are that rules? We will see now. Okay. So, the rules to find Thevenin's resistance. Are replace the voltage source or battery with its internal resistance and calculate the resistance of the network as viewed by the open circuit load terminals, that is view inwards from terminals A and B. So here what we are doing, here the first rule is that the voltage source, the battery which is available, we have to replace that battery with an internal resistance. Then we have to calculate the total resistance which is available in the network and viewing from the open circuit load terminals. Okay, that is to inwards of the from terminals A and B, and that is indicating RTH is equals to RI, that is internal resistance. So this is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit. The given circuit is replaced by Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So the parameters at load terminals are the current IL is equals to VTH divided by RTH plus RL, and the voltage VL is equals to IL into RL, and the power consumed PL is equals to VL into IL. So here the current passing through the load is IL, and the voltage across the load is VL, so this is a load resistance which is RL. Okay, to find out this current IL, this is equal to, if we observe, this RTH and RL are in series, okay. So, IL is equals to VTH by RTH plus RL. Okay. So what is VL? VL is equals to IL into RL. Okay. So what is the power consumed by RL? Is IL into VL. Okay. So these are the parameters at load terminals. Fine. We will understand by applying this Thevenin's theorem to a problem and by solving it. So how Thevenin's theorem is applied to a network. So here, using Thevenin's theorem, find the current through 3 ohms resistance in the circuit shown. Okay, so here the given circuit consisting of ~24 battery, 4 ohms, 12 ohms resistance and 3 ohms resistance. Here 3 ohms resistance is a load resistance which is across A and B, and the question is to find out the current through 3 ohms. So we have to find the current what is passing through 3 ohms. So previously when we discussed, when we going about the explanation of the Thevenin's theorem, so the current which is passing through RL, so here this A and B side resistance, we are treating this as a load terminal, load side, so load resistance. Okay, so the current passing through this resistance is load current, that is IL. So now, so we have to find out first step is that VTH, that is a Thevenin's voltage. So here the Thevenin's voltage is the open circuit voltage at load terminals. So it is a open circuit voltage at load terminals. So we have removed the load resistance and we kept this terminal A and B part as open. So we have to find out what is the resistance across A and B. That is, that will be the VTH. Therefore, open the load terminals as shown in the figure. Okay, here. So we have to find out what is the voltage across AB. So the voltage across AB is, so we have to find out. Okay. So applying voltage division rule. So by applying voltage division rule, voltage across 12 ohms resistance will be equal to, so the voltage across AB is nothing but the voltage across 12 ohms. So we have to find out the voltage across 12 ohms. So for finding the voltage across 12 ohms, so these are two are in parallel. So we have to go for a voltage division rule in order to find out the voltage across 12 ohms. So for that, we are using the voltage division rule. So how we have used it, how we have applied it, I will tell you. So here, for finding out the voltage of 12 volts, which is equals to, say here, now I am putting this as V2, okay. Just for understanding or simplicity, I am taking it as V2. So here V2 is equals to total voltage. What is the total voltage? Total voltage is 24 into, as we have to find out the voltage across 12 ohms, so it is 12 ohms divided by the total resistance, that is R1 plus R2, that is 4 plus 12. Okay, so 4 plus 12 is 16. So we will get it is totally 18 volts. So now we are getting the voltage across A and B is 18 volts, that is VOC is 18 volts, which is also equal to Thevenin's voltage. Okay, so the Thevenin's voltage is 18 volts. Okay, so now the second step is to find out the RTH. So how we will find out the RTH? We have to open the load terminal, load resistance, that is we removed the load resistance and we made it open. The terminal A and B is open now. And we have to find out the total resistance. For finding out the total resistance, whatever the voltage, if voltage is available in that network, voltage source is available in that network, we have to short it, or else if it has any internal resistance, we need to replace it with internal resistance or else with a short. If there is a current source, then we have to open that. Okay, so now replace the battery with its internal resistance. Okay, here Ri is not given, so that is internal resistance is not available, so it is, so we are shorting this. Okay, so if you observe here, we could able to view only the two resistors, that is 4 ohms and 12 ohms, and these two are in parallel. So when we are viewing from A and B terminal, 4 and 12 ohms are in parallel, so we have to find out the total resistance. So resistance as viewed from terminal A and B, RTH is equals to 4 parallel to 12, which is equals to 4 into 12 divided by 4 plus 12, which is equals to 48 by 16, that is 3 ohms. So the total resistance, that is RTH, Thevenin's resistance, is 3 ohms. So finally, we have to draw a Thevenin's equivalent with VTH and RTH in series as shown in figure. So total circuit, the given circuit, we are replacing with the single voltage source and single resistance, that is VTH and RTH. So we found the RTH value and VTH value. So we here VTH is 18 volts and RTH is 3 ohms. And we know that RL resistance also 3 ohms. Now we have to consider, we should put that 3 ohms in a circuit. So now this is an actual total circuit. So here now we have to find out the current which is flowing through the 3 ohms, that is across A and B. Okay. So which I is equals to here, RTH and RL both are in series. Okay, so according to Ohm's law, I is equals to V by R. So V is 18 ohms, VTH. We already know the formula, that is IL is equals to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. So likewise, we substituted. So VTH is 18 divided by 3 plus 3, 6. Okay, so the total current flowing through 3 ohms is 3 amps. Okay, so we found the current flowing through the load side resistance. So this is how we need to calculate and we need to apply the Thevenin's theorem to a given circuit. So this is an one example for understanding the Thevenin's theorem. In previous session, we have understood how to apply the superposition theorem. And the summary is that we have discussed about the statement and explanation of the Thevenin's theorem and Thevenin's theorem equivalent circuit for a given circuit. And we solved one problem also for understanding it and by applying the Thevenin's theorem. So we will see some quiz points. So VTH stands for Thevenin's voltage. The formula to calculate IL is VTH divided by RTH plus RL. While calculating RTH, one has to replace sources with their internal resistance. So here, while calculating VTH, you have to note down some points while calculating VTH and RTH. While calculating VTH, you have to consider the voltage across the open circuit voltage and while calculating RTH, we have to consider the resistance while viewing from the open circuit and putting all the voltage sources and current sources with their internal resistance. We have to replace it with internal resistance. Okay. So hope today's session is understood for everybody. We will also solve one more problem on the Thevenin's theorem in the next session, and we will even discuss about the one more theorem, that is Norton's theorem, in the next session. Thank you so much for listening to this session.